All right, so you can hire Hayabusa owners. I got a Hayabusa, right?
Okay.
So, this bitch, she's my bitch, so I can call her that. Then broke the chain, which is sitting right here, right? But it also broke the rod, clutch rod, and it disintegrated the seal. So what I had to do was go buy, I ain't got no money to split cases. So what I had to do, go buy one of these, a Dremel. Got me that little wheel there, you know what I'm saying? See if you can see the wheel. Okay, here it goes, see. And I grinded that fucking seal from the outside. From the outside. I popped that motherfucker out. It's a new chain and sprockets and shit. No leaks, no nothing. And I just came from a 80-mile ride. So I popped the seal from this side. Because you're supposed to crack the engine cases open to change that seal. I ain't got $2,000 to pay nobody for cracking no engine in half. Take the motor out, this motherfucker. I ain't got it. So I popped the seal from that side. And what I did was, as soon as I grinded enough that the seal popped out, I grinded a little. You can go ahead and grind. You can get aggressive with it. Make sure that seal goes in and out. So I ordered me a new one. And pop the new one in there. And then I saved the old one. Save your old seal, because you're going to put it on top of your new seal. I ordered the clutch push rod. I ordered the seal. It broke the case. I'll show you. It broke. It disintegrated itself. You know how they grenade themselves. That's not the right one. That's from a katana from my buddy. Did the same thing. Where the fuck am I? Where the hell is it? On this side? No, not on this side. Where the hell did it go? Did I throw it away? No, it ain't in there. Where the hell did it go? So here it is. So it broke. You can see it broke all of that. Common thing. Sometimes it'll break the water pump. This time I got lucky it didn't break the water pump. So this is what you got to do, guys. You grind that broken seal out. And even if the seal's good, you still got to grind it out to get the broken push rod, which is in my car. Let me see if I can find it. I'm going to show you all my stuff. Okay, here it is. Bear with me, because this is some good information. Good information. So, here's a rod that it broke. That motherfucker right there. Normally, this thing is about that long. Goes up to here. About 6 inches, give or take. So that piece was stuck inside that motor. And I'm over here on depression, drinking beer like a motherfucker, asking myself, what the fuck am I gonna do? So I started grinding that seal. Grinding around it until eventually it popped out. The old one popped out. The seal was still good, but the piece was inside the trans. soon as I popped the seal out, I was able to grab it with my fingers and pull that little piece out. Okay. Now, grind a little bit more and make sure that your new seal pops in there. So, when your new seal pops in, save your old one. Because you're going to put it on top of your new one. You're going to put your new seal, your old seal, and then you can make a little steel bracket, maybe that long, and you're going to put it on top of your old seal to hold your new seal in from the water pump. The water pump's got an 8mm bolt right next to that seal, that clutch rod seal. There's a bolt from the water pump right there. So get you a little steel bracket, and you want to make sure you, and it's flush. It's flush because you put a bracket, it's going to hold that, those two seals. It'll be flush and hold it in there forever. You don't need no glue. You don't need no epoxy. You don't need none of that crap. Like I said, I just finished mine. Went on an 80 mile trip just now. And there is no leaks on the ground. No leaks, period. So that's how you get around that problem. And the hell we're going to a shop that's going to charge you anywhere from $1,000 to $2,000 to split your cases and take the motor out your bike. You know, if you live in the Dallas, Texas area, let me know. I'll be more than happy to put a new seal in your bike. And you know what the good thing is? If it ever breaks it again, you ain't got to worry about it. All you got to do is take the bracket off. Pop your new seal in there. Take the broken push rod out. Pop your new seal in there, and you're good to go. Incredible, guys. Suzuki failed on that because I did a Katana last week. The chain broke. It broke the cover, and it broke the push rod. But Suzuki put a bracket over that seal. So that's what gave me the idea. So I finished my partner's bike, put a new chain, sprockets, I put a new clutch cover, rod, seal, literally in 1 hour. 1 hour, guys. So don't throw your bike away, man. If you got a Hayabusa that broke the chain and it needs help with the seal, or the piece is still broken in there, the push rod, the clutch push rod, don't throw your bike away. Don't give it away. It's only a 1 hour job. Get it back going. Parts will cost you, if you don't have, well, most likely you're gonna have to put sprockets and chain. Parts will cost you $250. You know, so just for you guys that ride boosters. Just so y'all know. Out.